Good morning, guys. Are we having our morning cup of coffee together? Here we have the live view from old people's webcam. Look at the dead trees. We got them up through here. Back up through here. Yeah. USGS did report a lot of the earthquakes that occurred over the weekend. Many of them they left off. And, yeah, they greatly downgraded many of them. But at least some of them they reported over, that occurred over the weekend. Generally, they don't do that. Once in a great while, they do. But maybe they know that I was reporting them, so they decided to put them in, even though the magnitude was greatly underestimated. On the 18th, it looks like, there was a magnitude 3.2 for Stanley, Idaho. 24 earthquakes they have listed as a magnitude 2.5 in the last 7 days. 273 in the last week. And they are only listing one so far today. And that is in Stanley, Idaho, a magnitude 2.6. But as you can see here, there's been a lot of earthquakes. Here we have Little West Thumb and the Promontory. And you can line up these earthquakes. Let me bring it down. It is currently 8:03 a.m. Central Daylight Time. And as you know, those of you that follow me, all the earthquakes marked in red is what the computer picked up. So then they sent a text message, more likely, to the phones or the home computers of USGS or the University of Utah. USGS would be in their office there in Menlo Park. I lived in Menlo Park years and years ago. Here is the stream view. The top monitor here would be Norris Geyser Basin. The middle would be Little West Thumb, and the bottom is Promontory. And you can see these earthquakes, the most recent earthquakes, they are on all three monitors. Right now, not being reported. Surprisingly, that signature did come in here at Little West Thumb and the Promontory. Just a little blip. Yeah, harmonic tremors, volcanic tremors. Go to the spectrogram. It's just a little thing that shows up here, being so far away. Here at the Promontory, it comes in as a magnitude 2.68. And we'll go back to its signature. Okay, the first wave would be the P wave, which goes directly through the earth, and then you go to the second wave, which would be the tallest one. That's where the S wave starts. That goes around the outside edge of the earth. So what about these other ones marked in red that they're not reporting right now? All right, we got one right there. A lot more heat came up, so it was probably there at the Promontory or Little West Thumb. That one comes in as a magnitude 2.86. I'll pull this down so you can see it. For those of you that are watching on your TV, see that at the bottom? 2.86. And there's its signature. Let me bring it back up for you. Next one this morning that is marked in red is right there. And let's take a look at its signature. Let me close this out. Sometimes when I go to another earthquake, it shows it much smaller. And I gotta close it and reopen it to get it to show up better. I've talked about how these signatures have been lasting a long time. Yeah, we got volcanic right there. And then we got harmonic tremors right there. That one comes in as a magnitude 2.64. Alright, the next earthquake marked in red is this little one right here. And we got one small one, and then there's a larger one afterwards. That small one comes in as a magnitude 1.75, and I'll try and get the next one. That second one comes in as a magnitude 2.32. And let's go there. Then we got another one, a series of them marked in red. All right, so let's try and get those. The first one would be probably a 1.98. I'll try and get the second one. That one would be a 1.79. And then the next one, let's pull it over, would be a magnitude 2.2. Yeah, that's the closest. Then we got another little tiny one right there. Let me close it out and reopen to see if I can get it bigger. All right, the next one there in red would be a magnitude 2.06. It could be as small as a magnitude 1.97. And then we got another one. That one's not marked in red. All right, then we got that one right there. That is marked in red. Possibly a 2.38. And then that's all I have right now. We got another small one right there. But that one is not marked in red. That comes in as a magnitude 2.0. And we'll go to the spectrogram. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Let me close this and make it bigger. Oh, it's not going to do it. Okay, sometimes it does that. When I close it and reopen it, there we go. Yeah, volcanic tremors. Earlier I had noticed we had a thickening of the lines, magma. They actually call it blobs of magma that was coming in. And then at Little West Thumb, it was just singing. Look at all those marked in red. Try and pull it down a little bit. There we go. Let's see if I can do that for this one here. Okay. So you can match up the times. It was coming in so fast and so loud. Yeah, we got high-pitched noises going on at the promontory, or at Little West Thumb, excuse me. And at the promontory, yeah, we got blobs of magma. And let's take a look at this. All right, so there's one section. 2 minutes and 25 seconds just after midnight, all this activity was going on. Yeah, look at that. Someone suggested I move my mouse along the edge of the keyboard to try and stay on the line. I'm going to try and do that. I'll put my... I don't know how I'm going to do that. Alright, hold on. Okay, I'm going to try that. Alright, so I'm moving it along the keyboard to try and stay on the line. That was a good suggestion. But I got my mouse pad here, so I can only go so far. Oh, yeah, see, I goofed up. I just don't have enough table room to do that. But look at this. Okay, this is where it was singing. Blobs of magma coming in. Yeah, and look how high the heat went up. I would say almost to the surface of the earth, to the crust of the earth where people are walking around. Yeah, look at that. Very concerning. You guys really should read that book on Catastrophe by Tim Washburn. It talks about Yellowstone Lake before the eruption, during the eruption, and after the eruption. How they just kept downplaying and poo-pooing the threat of another eruption. I mean, look at that. Let's go over here. Look at that. Unbelievable, huh? Let's look at the signature. See that? Yeah, we'll go back up over here. Can I? Alright, there's the signature for there and the spectrogram. Yeah, my grandson's here, and so is my granddaughter. And he's only 5. So, he does pretty good in keeping the noise down. Hold on, honey. So, here's the current thumb view for the different monitors. Lake Butte, the borehole, 208. That's at Yellowstone Lake, the promontory, Peachstone Plateau. Let me try and bring this down for you. Flag Ranch, Wyoming, Hawks Rest. East Entrance, Parker Peak, Norris Museum, yeah, and the borehole at Norris Junction. Let me bring that over for you. Oh, maybe Steamboat's going to go off again today. I don't know. In my last report I did about Yellowstone Lake, where the majority of the activity is occurring, I talked about this hydrothermal vent zone, which is on the probably the backside of Stevenson Island. Going back to Google Earth, I tried to draw out this area. That is one of the deepest areas of the lake, and the temperature down there at the bottom of the lake, which is about 390 feet deep, the temperature is about 340 to 350 degrees. Yeah, and then we got another area of a hydrothermal field close to what's over there? Let's see if we can find a name. No, just the road. Anyways, let's come over here. And one of them, yeah, it's near Dot Island. Here is Dot Island. And this is another hydrothermal field. But the biggest hydro field that is at Yellowstone Lake is this one up over here by Stevenson Island. You can see here the most recent earthquakes. This one showed up at Norris Geyser Basin, Little West Thumb, and at the Promontory, all three. And so did this one too, all three. And so far they're not reporting it. And once again, the program that I'm using is by USGS Swarm. This was developed by USGS to, I gotta close that out. Yeah. Look at the line of melt here. What was it when I pulled the files? Right there. Okay, and that was one of the more significant ones. Let's go to the spectrogram. Now again, this is Little West Thumb. Now I've talked about how the magma there that they've been tracking on the tilt meters is going eastward. So Little West Thumb, the magma's coming in, it's obvious, traveling under the lake and then going over here to the Promontory. And this is pretty close to the same time. And I wanted to show you what it was doing there at the Promontory during this time when all this magma was gushing in at Little West Thumb. Now, Little West Thumb was created by a hydrothermal eruption. They say between 162 to 150,000 years ago. But I am really wondering about their dates. Especially since my report I did about the trees. There weren't trees growing here until after the ice age ended. And that was 13,000, 11,000 years ago. Now, as the glaciers receded, there was less pressure pushing down on the earth. And that made it where these hydrothermal eruptions occurred, because the pressure was less holding it down. Now what my concern is with all these earthquakes at Yellowstone, and with the drought, we're going to have less pressure. And with the earthquakes, the magma's coming up, very well could have another hydrothermal eruption. I believe it was Mary's Bay when that one had its hydrothermal eruption. Now, they estimated about 13,000 years ago from what I remember here in my, between 3,000 and 14,000 years ago. That's a big gap in time. But that created a huge tsunami, throwing out debris and the tidal wave. Yeah, that inundated, a very large area. A very large area. And if something like that were to happen again, think of all the people that are at Fishing Bridge, down here at Grant Village. There would be a lot of death. and destruction. And then they got another area, several areas of hydrothermal eruptions in the past over here in this location. And then they got an area of inflation where it's rising up over there. And up over here is that newly discovered fault zone that they didn't even know existed. Yeah, we got the bridge here. It goes across the Yellowstone River. And this is that fault zone, the best I could draw out, for that newly discovered fault that they did not know exist. Yeah, they really haven't done adequate enough research about this supervolcano, which is the largest volcano in the world. Yeah, they thought it was a dead or dying volcano in the past. And now they know that it's not a dead or dying volcano, that it is recharging, has been recharging for another eruption for about 6,000 years. And they keep saying there is no threat for an eruption. Well, read that book, Catastrophe by Tim Washburn. Yeah. And the way they downgrade these earthquakes or don't even report them, I'm sorry, but I've caught them in so many lies. And you guys who watch my videos, you know exactly who I'm talking about. Yeah, I wouldn't believe anything they say. So thank you for having a cup of coffee with me as you watch the video. Thank you for your subscriptions. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Yeah, I'm going to have another cup of coffee now. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.